right here in studio right now. We have two guests that have been on the show a few times before, but separately. Now they combine and formed a Letho duo. And I'm not kidding you, man. This is some real talent right here, making some really, really great music. Her name's Rachel Berlin. His name is Taylor Pearson. And they are on Granite State of Mind. So let's hear it. Feel it out, bro. Welcome back to Granite State of Mind, everybody. We're trying to work out some technical stuff here, and I think we got it. Everybody, Granite State of Mind, 95.3 FM. Ben Harris, Rachel Berlin, Taylor Pearson right here in studio. All singer-songwriters, all contributors to the New Hampshire music scene for many years now. Rachel, you're on it. I mean, you've been, what, three years at this right now?
Yeah, 2 or 3 years I've been performing, but it's really this past year that I've gotten heavily
into it.
Yeah.
Yeah, and getting comfortable, but more and more comfortable with it. Is it,
I used to get really nervous before going up on stage, but now I just show up.
Yeah.
No expectations.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. And your music is so well received, is what I'm trying to say. You know what I mean? And it's like from the second I had heard you sing, you know, it's a pleasure to hear you sing, not only because you sing differently than nearly any singer-songwriter that in New Hampshire that I can think of, you have definitely your own voice. And not surprisingly, I guess when that Meat on the Bone song that I've heard maybe 3 or 4 times now, just a beautifully composed,
thank you so much,
lyrically, I mean, on point song, beautifully sung, great playing, you know, as a combo. Just want to let you know that. I mean, you know, everybody, I'm sure, always talks about your voice and all that stuff, but your lyrics, beautiful stuff there, man. I had mad respect for that. So tell me something. Why is this combo working? Ben Harris walked in, and Taylor is somebody who's been in a whole bunch of bands and still is. He's carried his own band, punk bands, and he does the outlaw country stuff, and he's just one of the nicest guys and one of the biggest talents. And when Baron Harris walked in, he said something like, boy, I wouldn't have seen this coming from a mile away. Tell us how come it works.
Well, I just met Taylor.
Bring that mic just so we don't miss anything.
Yeah.
Go ahead.
Yeah. I just met Taylor like a few months ago through Brian Burnout, actually.
Yeah.
And I don't know. I think it works because Taylor is really just taking the time to like learn how I play.
Mm-hmm.
And I mean, not everyone can just play along to what I'm doing that easily.
Yep.
But he's really sat down to take the time to learn. And he really seems to love my songs. And I think that helps a lot.
Yeah.
And we've been playing together pretty regularly and just trying to smooth everything out.
And that's what you're looking for. Somebody that you can trust, right?
Exactly.
That has trust in you, that trusts where you're going, even though he has no idea where you're going initially, right? Like when he meets you and singing, and I'm sure he brought you down some roads that maybe you weren't going, and you're like, oh, this is nice. We meet there.
For sure.
So, yeah and you get to learn from him, and you get to be working with a very... Go ahead, pal.
Is this thing on? Yeah.
Yeah.
You hit it right on the head, Rob. She's got real unique lyrics, but real unique songwriting for the area. And it's been a real pleasure playing with her and learning her songs. So it's forced me to innovate my playing style.
Yeah, man.
You know, take it to the next level and try something new. And that's very exciting, you know, especially when you're someone like me who's been playing for so many years and in some of these projects for going on a decade or more, it's nice to change it up and get a different feel going.
Right. And evolve. I mean, you know, go to a different place and be willing to go to a different place. You know what I mean, Taylor? And that's big too.
Yeah, absolutely. You know, for me, music's like the greatest adventure of my life. So having something new and exciting and a new world to explore is right up my alley.
And I wonder if your experience writing and working with Rachel will bleed into your own stuff that would be separate from Rachel.
Oh, sure. I mean, kind of the new guitar tones I've been crafting and new style of playing I've been using on her songs that, you know, I hadn't really played before is now already bleeding into stuff. Like, I'm going to be taking this little orange amp into the studio for Hometown Eulogy in the next month or so.
Yeah.
And do some of this kind of like pedal steely sounding, yeah, reverby, you know, kind of atmospheric guitar playing, and kind of use that to back up some of our like bluegrass and Americana songs, mm-hmm, just to like kind of flush things out in the studio. And it's not something I get to do live all the time, but yep, it's, you know, a new creative thing I get to bring into my recording work.
That's great. And props to you too, you know, for letting Rachel jump on your back, you know what I mean, and guiding her. You know, everybody needs, you know, guidance in all of this. Right up until the end of life, I think you need guidance. Yeah. And anytime you can find somebody who's willing to say, get on my back, you know, and then I'll jump on yours and, you know, we'll make it work.
Totally.
Yeah. Granite State of Mind here, 95.3 FM, WMNH. Don't forget, Ben Harris is in the house and he'll be up around 6:30 or so. You were talking about playing live. I hope you bring hometown into Pembroke City Limits, where we get a nice slice of Rachel tomorrow night. A double set tomorrow night, double billing with Kate West, starts at like 7 o'clock show, I think.
I think
6:30.
What we settled on.
Yes, 6:30.
It's loose.
Yeah, it's loose. Rachel, I think, is going to be opening up for Kate West and plays like an, I don't know, hour and 15 minutes, something like that. Then we'll take a break. And then the great Kate West, who just blew the roof off the place when we did the Nirvana Unplugged up at Pembroke City Limits last Saturday. It was by far the biggest crowd we ever had, the biggest night we've had. It's been two. Acoustic Dead was a huge night, and Nirvana Unplugged was a huge night. And I'm sure tomorrow will be the same. Come on by, everybody. All right, what's the next on tap?
This next song is called Locked My Heart Away.
And when did you write this?
I wrote this last summer.
Nice, man. All right, right here, Rachel Berlin.
Give my heart away.
What a beauty right there, man. Rachel Berlin, Taylor Pearson right here on Granite State of Mind. Another great song. A very confessional song. Yep, very revealing there. You know, if anybody, because you are a bit of a mystery. You know what I mean? You are a bit of a mystery. I think people might have, I don't know what people would assume. I can just tell you what I did. You know what I mean?
Yeah,
okay, I'll just tell you my initial thing. I think I've known you for a couple of years right now. Yeah. You're slightly intimidating, right? I think others might think that. I don't know.
Maybe.
Right? Slightly intimidating.
She's bold.
Yeah, you're bold. Your presence alone, you know, you've just got something, right? You got something right there. That is just, you have a strong aura to you. You know what I mean? You're an old soul to me. You know what I mean? I bet you I've got 30 years on you. You know what I mean? You're an old soul in a very young, you're a young lady, man. How old are you? 23?
21.
You're 21 years old. That's hilarious. And that's hilarious, right? But that's what it is. And then if I was to ask you, you know, about your songs, your lyrics, who you are, there it is. You're saying you haven't been willing or not even capable of giving love away.
That's last summer. That's how I felt, because there was this man who was trying to open my heart.
Uh-huh.
I was struggling, but he eventually cracked it open.
He did. He cracked the walnut.
He sure did. And now I'm just falling in love left and right.
You are. Yeah. That's great. So that song came from that before or after you, before her or after you cracked?
Before.
Yeah, huh?
Or in the process.
Right.
Yeah. Song kind of actually helped me open my heart.
That's a beautiful thing. That's a beautiful thing. You hear it. The lyrics are, again, great lyrics. You know, now I don't have to ask you those questions, you know what I mean? Because all you have to do is read those lyrics, hear you sing those. So congratulations, a breakthrough. Have you written a song about breaking through, you know, that love divide? Yet.
Yes.
Yeah.
I was like, you know, I need to write a song that's a little bit more upbeat.
Now I'm falling in love.
You know, because all my songs are so kind of sad and mellow. So actually just recently, a month ago,
yeah,
I wrote a song that, you know, has a little bit more love and light.
Yeah, that's great. That's a great line right there. Now I'm falling in love left and right. You know what I mean? That's great. Granite State of Mind here, 95.3 FM, WMNH. Tell us where you're playing next weekend, and you got a Brattleboro date?
Yeah, October 10th, I'm opening for Danny Ray Clark, who's a touring musician from Nashville.
Mm.
The address, you'd have to reach out to me at Rachel Berlin. That's my Instagram. The L in Berlin is the number one. It's downtown Brattleboro in some penthouse apartment.
Yeah.
Should be exciting. I think this man named Wes Pierce and Slow Pony will also be there.
How did you get that gig?
This man, Slow Pony, reached out to me.
Okay. Had he seen you perform before?
I had seen him perform, and then I reached out to him on Instagram.
Nice.
So we've just been connected since then.
Somebody's going to be wanting to manage you soon.
Yeah, I could use the help, honestly.
They all could. That's half the grind, right, Ben?
Yeah.
I mean, just that's half the grind of being a musician is ridiculous, but it's tough. Well, good for you. So you're playing up there in Berlin. Go to your Instagram page, and that's not an N at the end. It's a one.
No, it's the L in Berlin.
Oh, I'll let you do
one.
Okay.
Rachel Berlin, L in Berlin is the number one.
Yeah, nice. And again, Pembroke City Limits. What about you, Taylor? What else you got?
Well, let's see. We got Will Hatch & Co. coming up at the Feathered Friend Brewery.
Nice.
On September 28th.
Nice.
If you haven't been in to check out Feathered Friend in Concord, it's a great local brew place and good live music and a sweet outdoor stage out back. So definitely come check that out. And then we're doing a double weekend with Hometown Eulogy out in East Washington. They've got an artisan craft fair going on out there.
Yeah.
And we're playing on Sunday the 29th. And we're also playing on October 5th out there doing some of our, you know, our standard Americana tunes.
Yep.
A lot of stuff that's coming out on our new record that we've been working on. So if you want to come down and see us play and... see my man John Orsi and his masterfully crafted bowls that he turns. So
okay,
check out some great craftsmen and some great music.
Good stuff right there. Taylor Pearson, Rachel Berlin, and don't forget Ben Harris up next with He's been down in Nashville recording, and he's got the receipts to prove it tonight, right? Had a boy right here. What was I going to ask you? Okay, let's talk real quickly about you and Taylor. Our recording, George Laliotis, you're recording with him. How many songs you got down?
So far, we've got three. I think we're going to start with just a short EP.
Yeah.
And then once those are out, work on a full-length album.
Yeah.
We have Audrey Buddington playing violin.
Beautiful.
As well.
Mm-hmm.
So yeah, we just need some bass tracks and some harmonies and percussion.
Is this all exciting to you?
I'm psyched.
Yeah.
I'm ready to kind of like close this chapter of my songwriting and move on to the next.
Yeah, man. Yeah. Very exciting. I love it. Granite State of Mind here, 95.3 FM WMNH, and I guess I can promote too. So tonight, if you're out and about, get on up to the Suncook Village. We're trying to build something there, and I think we're doing a pretty good job so far, brick by brick. That's our motto. So we got Carl and Niv are a great couple in a duo. They're playing tonight at 7 o'clock to 9 o'clock. And then tomorrow night, again, Kate West and Rachel Berlin. That's a 6 o'clock, 6:30 to 9 or whatever show. And then we've got Brooks Young is on Sunday. He's bringing Nothing But the Blues series up there. So Brooks will be there, and I think he's bringing a keyboardist with. We'll have the Patriots on and everything else going on up there. Don't forget, love you, Sleazy Vegan. And all right, let's nail one more tune, and then we'll get Ben on here. Is that cool?
Sounds good.
Are you in the mood for one more?
Yeah, absolutely.
Okay.
There is a false ending, so don't talk too soon.
Okay.
All right?
Me. Can't shut me up, but you're right. I step on people all the time. All right, Granite State of Mind, 95.3 FM.
All right, this song is called Wandering One Ways. I'm good at being on my own. But tonight I don't wanna be alone, and I feel so misunderstood, just like you said I would. And I'm free as a dove, and that's why I'm so hard to love. My spirit molds and it shapeshifts. My mind takes off and it drifts, and I wish I could make you understand the realms of my unconscious land, and I laid myself bare under down those wandering one ways, and I'm wandering one ways. I'm wandering one ways, one ways. I'm wearing my best disguise. Visions of flame are strong, so strong I can't go wrong. And I wanted to love you.
down those wandering one ways, and I'm wandering one way. I'm a wandering one ways, one way. And I know I may not look the part, but in my aching heart, to know a destiny weaver, and it's not easy to love a dreamer.
Phenomenal, man. Phenomenal. Rachel Berlin, Taylor Pearson right here. I sit here and, you know, you don't remember what 1978 was like, but sometimes when I hear you sing, I feel like I'm walking past my parents' living room in 1978, and they just finished watching a Woody Allen film. Mm-hmm. You know, that's the vibe. You're not in 80s, you're not 90s. It's something from way back, yeah. Way back. And it's a pleasure to watch you both come together to add another element to your talent. You're one of the musicians in New Hampshire that I truly believe has maybe the most, I think you're going to get a lot of opportunities once somebody sees you. Well, you know what I mean? I really do. I really do think, you know, the world's your oyster out there. Somebody is going to get a hold of you. And I see you in the vein of Sierra Farrell. You know what I mean? Mm-hmm. And it's like, my God, if all you got to do is get meat on the bone in the right person's hands. That's the thing. You got to get that thing in the right person's
hands. Well, it's always going to be in my hands.
That's
first
right.
First of all.
You're the boss. You're the boss,
yeah,
right?
I'll get it into people's ears, but they're in my hands.
Right. I'm with you. But, you know, you'll go do the show in Brattleboro. Yeah. And I'm sure that that woman that you're opening up for, is she's out touring now, right?
Yeah, starting there. To connect with her.
Yeah, you guys better
expand
stop making. I think you better get ready to make some travel plans, because you're going to be pretty busy coming up. Anyway, such a pleasure. 95.3 FM. I'll see you tomorrow.
Yes, you will.
And I'll see you. You let me know whenever you guys are done with that album. You want to, if you ever want to come by Pembroke City Limits and play.
Oh, we'll have a party.
Okay, good. We'll have a party.